So I want you to imagine that you're the vice president of sales at some huge company. You have a whole team of salesmen working long hours trying to sell your product. They're following up on leads, cold calling people, even going door to door in order to generate more revenue. One day you're walking around the office and you're listening in on one of your staff, a new hire who's on the phone with some new prospect. "Yes ma'am, that won't be any problem at all. We'll be glad to help you. And don't worry, I understand how urgent it is. In fact, this used to be an issue with me too, so I totally empathize with you." You think to yourself, "Wow, this kid's pretty good. He's making the customer feel comfortable, explaining how the product will benefit their life, and he's coming across like a relatable friend instead of a salesman. This should be in the bag. All he has to do now is ask them to buy." You look on eagerly to your employee, waiting for the close. Then he just hangs up the phone. "Wait, what?" You're super confused. You walk over to your worker. "Hey, that call sounded like it was going really well. What happened? Why didn't you try to close the sale?" Then the new hire looks at you and says, "Yeah, that's kind of what I do. I get real close to making the sale, make the prospect on the other line love me, then I hang up. Don't really feel like asking them to buy." Now, let's take a step back to realize just how ridiculous the scenario is. I mean, how mad do you think you would be as the boss in this situation? Like a salesman who doesn't sell? That's just stupid, right? Well, truth is, I see this kind of behavior all the time. But not with salesmen choosing not to close their prospects. It's with guys choosing not to make a move when they're with the girl they want. They'll talk about safe topics, beat around the bush, act all friendly and whatnot, yet be too scared to simply ask for a number or Instagram. And if you think about it, it's not that much different in terms of how ridiculous it is. A salesman having a great call, yet not trying to get the sale, is a lot like a guy who's in an amazing conversation with an attractive girl, and she's laughing and totally into him, yet he doesn't want to try anything. Thinking back to my younger days, I remember countless times when I was trying to flirt with a girl, and maybe she was even responding positively to me, but I'd be too scared to do anything. I remember thinking, "I want to ask for a number, but I don't want to come off as creepy." And this is actually the most common reason I get when I ask students, "Hey, what happened back there? Everything seemed like it was going great." Most of the time, they'll say they're scared of seeming like an asshole or a creep, but here's the truth. Ready? If she's already flirting with you, then not making a move is creepy, not the other way around. I mean, think about it. If she's already giving you multiple signs that she's into you, like staying there with you more than 10 minutes, smiling, laughing at your jokes, eye contact, all that, then she expects you to make a move. And if you don't, then that is gonna come off weirder and creepier than whatever you were going to do if you had the balls to. Once you've realized this, you're much more likely to actually make a move next time things are going well with a girl. Now, maybe you're thinking to yourself, "But what if I'm too socially awkward to know she's into me or not? How will I know if I should make a move then?" My answer to that is simple. Try anyways. If the problem is that you lack the social awareness to know whether or not she wants you to make a move, then that is a skill that can only be honed through practice. Only by trying to close a lot and getting rejected will you gain the experience and skill of picking up on certain social cues that'll let you know when to make a move and when not to. I guess you can almost say that failure isn't always a bad thing as long as you learn from it. Yeah, I know. Crazy concept, right? So now that we've talked about the importance of having a closer's mindset when you're engaging with a cute girl, let's talk different ways you can escalate or close. You could try something more physical if you're out at a bar or a club, like going for a kiss or dancing with her. For example, let's say you're showing off your moves on the dance floor and you notice one of the girls close by is checking you out, maybe even giving you a smile. Instead of just standing there and smiling like most guys would, go up and dance right next to her. Do it with a smirk to convey fun energy. If she's into you, a lot of the times she'll lean in and start bumping and grinding on you. If you're on a date, you could try holding her hand or kissing her if you get the feeling she's interested. Or maybe you meet a cute girl at a bookstore and you two end up having half an hour of amazing conversation with laughing and flirting. You could suggest a date. "Hey, you seem awesome. We should get coffee sometime, finish up this conversation about our favorite animals, and then ask for her number." Basically, the point I'm trying to make is that how you choose to close has to have context. Where are you meeting the girl? Is it random or are you two already on a date? Is it a high energy place like a club where kissing a stranger is no big deal, or a daytime place like a coffee shop where it's probably best to suggest hanging out sometime and getting her contact info? These are all things you should be keeping in your mind to make sure you come across as socially adjusted, not some creep. One more thing, asking for her number I guess is making a move, but in my experience, it often leads nowhere unless she gives you the number after a flirty vibe was already established. If you're keeping the interaction just friendly and nice, then you ask for a number, chances are she'll give you the number, but it'll be a number that likely just leads to the friend zone. Again, it's all about context. So, now that we've discussed the importance of having that initiative to make a move when things are going well, let's go over some action steps you can take in order to start implementing next time you go out. So we're gonna go from newbie level to advanced based on how much anxiety you have or what you're comfortable doing. Level 1. Ask for a high five. You can go up to a stranger to do this, a cute girl, someone you're talking to, etc. A lot of guys have too much anxiety to even do this, so it's a good place to start. Level 2. A direct compliment. So something like, "By the way, you look freaking amazing in that dress." Something that shows her you find her attractive to establish the flirty premise. Level 3. So the same thing as level 2, a direct compliment, but this time you're gonna suggest to hang out sometime, then ask for her number, Instagram, or contact info at the end. Notice how you ask for her number after already making things flirty. Like we mentioned before, a number ain't worth much unless it has context. Level 4. At this more advanced level, if you're comfortable with showing intent and going for a close, you can try something more physically direct, leading her to the dance floor, playfully giving her a twirl, or holding her hand. Level 5. At this level, you should be able to consistently have amazing fun interactions with girls, making them super attracted. At this level, it's time to start being very direct. Lots of flirty touching, going for the kiss, and then eventually taking her home. So to summarize, today we talked about the importance of getting to the point, of manning up and making a move. It's like that movie The Wolf of Wall Street, always be closing. We explained how a lot of guys are too scared of seeming creepy to make a move with the girl they like, when in reality, it's actually creepier to not make a move if a woman is showing you she's interested. We also went over some specific ways to close depending on the context of the situation, such as getting her contact info after already setting a sexual romantic frame between you two, getting physical with her through touching, dancing, and kissing, and then even bringing her back home if she's giving you signs she wants to. So basically, any attempt to get her to accept this man-to-woman energy between you two is a form of a close. That's it for the video, guys. Real quick, I want to give a huge thank you and welcome to all the new subscribers. By the time this video drops, I think we'll have passed 35,000 subscribers, which is insane to me considering we were under 4,000 on Thanksgiving. What an insane way to end the year. I can't wait to see where we get to by the end of 2020. So another quick note, I try my best to put out top quality animation in all my videos, such as in the last two videos I dropped. From time to time, however, videos will be in this more traditional whiteboard animation style for cost-cutting purposes. The next few videos should be back to the higher quality animation though, so don't worry about that. Anyways, if you like this, do me a favor and share it with a friend who you think needs to hear it. Besides that, I have an awesome video coming out next week, so make sure to like and subscribe, and as always, peace.